Saturday, August 25th, 2018, was Take Your Daughter for a Workout Day. So Stephanie and I worked out on 13,000-foot Mount Chiquita in Rocky Mountain National Park. Mount Chiquita is a peak in what is called the Mummy Range. With imagination, the mummy can be seen lying down, stretched out on his back. We departed Longmont at 4 a.m. and began hiking at the first light, 5:55 a.m. Alpenglow was hanging low on the early horizon, illuminating the mountaintops like warm pillows in the cool mountains. In sharp outline shadows of gray, the mountain seemed to say, "Welcome to a new day, peaceful and serene." We saw two bull elk and one buck deer grazing among the trees. The low-growing tundra grasses and flowers are delicate. We stayed on the trails as much as possible. If damaged, it can take 100 years to rejuvenate. At the high-low trail split, we took the high trail to Mount Chiquita's summit. On the return, we hiked the low trail back. Mountain rocks are classed as boulders, talus, and small marble-like scree. This trail has a lot of talus to negotiate through. At 7:45, 1 hour and 50 minutes, we arrived at the Mount Chapin and Lower Trail crossing.
Pan around down here, and this is the lower trail that we will take when we go back. And ahead here is Stephanie going up the trail to Chiquita.
Here's a view of one of the many spectacular valleys. The ragged south face of Mount Chapin falls away into the valley far below. This is a view of the Alpine Visitor Center at the top of Trail Ridge Road, the highest paved road in the U.S. The mountain in back of Stephanie is 12,454-foot Mount Chapin. I summited that one on Friday, August 7, 2015, with Ira Struble, Clyde Inman, Carl Arnold, and Dick Conaway. While ascending Mount Chiquita, we briefly encountered some sleet from the edge of a passing storm cloud, but we were rewarded with a beautiful rainbow. We reached the summit at 9:20, which was 3.5 hours from the Chapin Pass trailhead. The summit was windy and quite cool, so Stephanie kept on her white rain jacket, and my windbreaker was just right for tromping around the summit. The summit is covered with talus, but it's very easy to negotiate, so we had no problem at all. There are two rock wind shelters on the top of Mount Chiquita, but both are really too low to be of much protection. The mountain in the background is 13,514-foot Mount Ypsilon. A trail leads down from Mount Chiquita to a saddle, then a steady upward climb to the top of Ypsilon. That mountain is named for the distinct steep couloirs or troughs that form the letter Y on the east face. Ypsilon is the letter Y in the Greek alphabet. We were thinking about doing Ypsilon until I remembered this song. Here's a sampling of the tundra grass, lichens, and other plants that we saw. Long's Peak in the background is the tallest 14er on Colorado's Front Range. I summited Long's on Saturday, August 3rd, 2013, with 19-year-old Patrick Conaway on a 17.5-hour hike. Marmots are classified as large squirrels. There are 15 species of marmots. Marmots typically live in burrows, often within rock piles, particularly in the case of the yellow-bellied marmot, as seen here, and they hibernate there through the winter. Marmots mainly eat greens and many types of grasses, berries, lichens, mosses, roots, and flowers. Most of the summer flowers have already dried up and blown away. Here are a few of the yellow flowers that still remain. Here we are back at the trail split for Chapin and Mount Chiquita. And we're taking the low road or low trail on the way back. The return trail was sunny and warm, with excellent views of the mountains, valleys, and meadows. The tundra trail finally gave way to woodlands, pine, spruce, and some marshes. This hike was rewarding for the variety of ecological zones that we traversed. Here is a Rocky Mountain ground squirrel who thinks he's king of the mountain. This section of the trail we named the staircase. It's steep, but with good rock steps built into it. But attention and care is needed whether you're going up or down. We returned to the Chapin Pass trailhead at 12:30, a wonderful 6.5 hour hike. But wait, there's more. Yeah, right, now pay me. Marmot Point is right below the Alpine Visitor Center. Old Fall River Road is one way up only, so we decided to add a second summit to a day of hiking. Marmot Point's elevation is 11,909 feet. The Marmot Point is a small knob that overlooks Chapin Creek and the Fall River Valley. This trail took exactly 20 minutes to get to the top. Dark clouds were moving in, and that's the reason why we always start our long hikes early in the morning. Well, the take your daughter to a workout day went better than expected and was much prettier than our original plan to hike a 14er named Mount Bierstadt, which was forecast for bad weather. The CCY, Chapin Chiquita Ypsilon area, is worth another visit next summer when I'll be 75. Can't wait. Brag, brag. Stephanie, thanks for a great day in Rocky Mountain National Park.